The reason we're investing in this facility, which has been around since the 1960s, is because it is a major natural gas processing facility in an area that has renewed development activity. This is a great example of investment in aging infrastructure, which can prolong the life of an asset that's very important to the region and to industry players. My name is Kevin Keenan. I'm the asset manager for the South District with TAQA North. This facility was constructed in the 1960s to process natural gas from a deep sour gas reservoir right beneath our feet. And as sour gas feedstock declined over time, we were hitting the lower limit of what was required to operate the sulfur recovery process efficiently. We reviewed a number of alternatives and made the decision that acid gas injection was the right decision to take for this facility.
Acid gas is a byproduct of the plant's sweetening process. Previously, this gas was processed to obtain sulfur for sale, with any leftover gas being mixed with additional fuel and burnt. This led to higher greenhouse gas emissions. Now, they channel all of this gas into a well, 2.7 kilometers underground. Since there is no longer a need to burn extra fuel, they no longer need an incinerator stack, and the process reduces greenhouse gas emissions by 50%.
My name's Gordon Gardner. I am the East Crossfield Plant Foreman. The acid gas injection project gives us the flexibility to both sequester our own acid gas that we remove from the raw feedstock to the facility, but in addition to that, sequester third-party acid gases that may be produced or recovered from other industries in the area. The acid gas injection project at the East Crossfield Plant had a total cost of approximately $30 million, $10 million of which was from the government of Alberta through Emissions Reduction Alberta.